just let me coach ya, show you about my culture. It's a late night show like Kona. Bitch, the party ain't over.
Before I even came up with the term Neon Future, I was thinking of just this convergence of technology and science and where we're going, with extending our lives, expanding our brains, understanding the brain, which is already, it's such a mystery, but as we are unlocking different parts of the brain, we're learning so many different really interesting things. So yeah, Neon Future seemed to be like the best term. It's like I think of the future in neon. I think of the future as, a bright, positive utopian world. From all the books I've been reading, from Ray Kurzweil to Aubrey de Grey, notably those two that are actually both on the album. Ray's introducing the album and Aubrey's closing the album. And Ray talks about this technological evolution that we're going in, leading to singularity. And Aubrey de Grey talks about, he has a book called Ending Aging, where he talks about how aging, if we could treat it like it's a disease that we can cure, like something where it's not inevitable anymore, by understanding why cells degenerate or die off. And really interesting stuff. And they're doing lots of research around that. So if we can reverse this cell mutation and all the problems, we could live indefinitely, sure. Which is really cool stuff.
So you touched on the Ray Kurzweil thing. I wanted to talk a little bit about the documentary series that you're doing,
yeah,
that kind of accompanies that. So you've got some really interesting kind of subjects. Speaking about Ray Kurzweil, you mentioned Ariana Huffington's one of the other ones as well. How, yeah, did you go about choosing the interviewees for this project?
Well, I first started off with scientists or futurists that I've been reading about. And Ray was the first one. I already had him cameo in, I wrote a song called Singularity, so I had him cameo in the music video, and I started talking with him more over email, and then I interviewed him in his apartment, and like he lives up in the Google offices, like up there in San Francisco area. And then I reached out to Aubrey Gray, read his book on life extension, and then I started thinking, you know what, I want to start interviewing people that are just interesting, that are interested to interview with a little DJ like me. So Ariana Huffington was promoting her book, Thrive. It's almost like a little bit, not anti-technology, but it's taking a step away from technology to find yourself. That's her whole theme. And so I went to her place in New York and interviewed her, and went up to Oxford about 6 weeks ago and interviewed Richard Dawkins, which was great because, I read a few of his books and I'm a big fan of his, so would love, wanted to hear what he had to say about his version of the future. I interviewed Stan Lee, who was the founder of Marvel Comics. And I mean, talk about science fiction. He's been writing science fiction stories for 50 years. So that interview was incredible. And then I teamed up with Wired Magazine, who are like a perfect partner because they're so developed in the tech space and they're like the Bible of the tech industry. So they helped put together the Ray Kurzweil interview that's up online right now.
Who's been your favorite so far? You mentioned Stan Lee.
I mean, they're so different, all of them are really cool, they all have different stories, and the list is getting longer and longer if people want to interview, because it's no longer just scientists and philosophers. It's just anyone that I've read like a lot of different books from a lot of different amazing minds I'd love to talk to, So I'd love to continue this forward. Now it's just a matter of time and availability, because I mean, not just touring, but I'm in the studio finishing Neon Future Part 2, and then outside of that, I have other stuff. So I have to fit this part in to go. I flew to Oxford specifically to interview Richard Dawkins, but it's like my own personal interest to go there. Like all this stuff is my own personal interest. I want to talk to them anyways. I want to meet them face to face and sit down and have just a conversation, and that's basically what they are.
Cool. So going back to the album, you've got quite a few collaborators on there. Can you talk us through some of them?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty diverse. Fall Out Boy. Then I have some hip hop collaborators like Waka Flocka, Kid Ink, MGK. one of UK's greatest producers, Flux Pavilion, Afrojack as well. We did our like follow up to No Beef, Will I Am, which is our third track we did together, and Empire of the Sun, and Luke Steele from Empire of the Sun, and they're all different. They all have their own place in the neon future, and I'm excited to see what the UK will grasp onto, because I know it's every territory has been different as far as what people have been really excited about.
What are your touring plans for the album?
Touring plans? Well, I'll be back out here in February, most likely doing Brixton Academy again, and played this year at Brixton Academy, and to this day is honestly one of my favorite shows I've ever done. You know, it was an unexpected sold out show. Like, I didn't expect to sell it out at all. I didn't think that would happen. And then the amount of like reaction and energy from the crowd was, you know, I mean, it means a lot to me, because UK is kind of like that it's a very delicate country for me. I really want to put a lot of time and attention out here.
You recently did a pretty lengthy residency at Pasha in Ibiza as well. How was that?
That was great. Actually, just being in Ibiza for the summer opened me up as far as the way I produce music, as you know, has definitely changed. I've like started thinking about how to produce songs in a different way. I have my own studio in Ibiza, so I actually started writing a lot when I was out there. And 18 weeks at Pasha straight every Wednesday, something I haven't done. You know, I haven't done that in a long time. I mean, I used to do that in LA. I had a weekly residency in LA, but it's different. Like doing something like that at that scale at Pasha in Ibiza, you know, and you know, every single week there was a different like co-headlining guest, and that would DJ with me. And there's a lot of us back to back DJing, and I was just, it's a lot of fun, a lot of spontaneity, a lot of growth, a lot of like digging through different kinds of libraries of music and soaking all that new music in.